Namaskar, I am Shoma Banerjee. Welcome to Amader Bangali Rannaghar channel. Today I'll be making tel koi or climbing perch in oily gravy. It's a very traditional dish of Bengalis. So let us have it in our kitchen. So welcome to my kitchen. These are the climbing perch. I have cleaned them properly and I have added salt and turmeric. And now I'll be using a little bit of mustard oil. And I'll keep them marinated for at least 30 minutes. Now, one thing I'll tell you, climbing perch, they are alive for a long time, as we know. Everybody, each one of us know that. And climbing perch should be cut with great precision. So if you're not an expert, please don't take a risk. Ask your fishmonger to do the same. See, I have already got them and now I have marinated them and I'll keep them outside at room temperature for about 30 minutes. So let's marinate it. For the gravy, I'll need ginger, 1/2 inch, red chilies, but the number of chilies may vary according to the degree of hotness you want, and cumin. Now I'll be frying them in the kadhai and then making a paste of it. You may also add a tomato if you want. Into a cast iron kadhai with just one drop of oil, I'm just frying the cumin, the ginger and the red chilies, and also I have added tomatoes to it. Though in the traditional oil gravy of the climbing perch, tomato is not added, but for the red color, I'll be adding this tomato to the gravy, and now I'll make a smooth paste out of it. I have heated my iron kadhai and now I'll be adding mustard oil. The kadhai is very hot, it's very well heated because that's the trick of frying a fish properly. The kadhai must be heated and the oil must also be equally heated. And for this particular preparation, mustard oil is a must, or else you will not get that pungent flavor of the fish and the cooking. The recipe, the speciality of the recipe is the pungent flavor actually. So I have heated it, and now that the oil is heated, I'll be adding the fish one by one. Just a word I would like to add. In the traditional gravy, oil gravy of climbing perch, we don't add any vegetables. But since it is the beautiful winter and cauliflowers are plenty in the market, I'll be adding cauliflowers and some green peas. So for frying, I have to fry the cauliflowers. You can see what I have done. I have just diced them into bigger pieces, the florets into bigger pieces, and I've added salt and turmeric. And I'll just fry it once my fish get fried in the same oil. My fish is fried. They are crisp and very well fried, you can see. And now in the same oil, I'll be frying the cauliflowers in small batches. The florets, I've already applied turmeric and salt, and I'll be frying them in small batches. So here goes the one. In the oil, I have spluttered some nigella seeds and green chilies, and I've added the cumin paste. The cumin ginger paste, you remember what I had done. And now I'll be adding a little bit of salt and turmeric powder. I'll fry it well. You can see the mixture, the masala is actually leaving the sides of the bowl, but still it has to be fried well. So I'm going to fry it for at least 2 to 3 minutes more. My spices are, you can see how well and the rich color you can see. I can smell also, the frying is almost done. At this moment, I'll be adding green peas and let it cook for another maybe 1 minute, not more than that. So let it get cooked. The sugar has to be added after the masala is absolutely fried. The salt and turmeric, which I've already added. Now I've added a little bit of water, not more than 100 ml, and I have just scraped the sides so that the masala gets fried well. And at this moment, I'll be covering and cooking for another 2 minutes. My masala is ready for the gravy. At this time, I'll just add few granules of sugar, just a few granules. It will add the richness of the color. And now that it's done, I will be adding the cauliflowers and I'll be cooking them a little more in the gravy so that the gravy enters the cauliflower. The florets get well cooked and soaked in the gravy. My the florets of cauliflower have got soaked in the gravy and the gravy has come to a boil. I'll add water, but make sure I don't add too much of water, otherwise it will become too watery, which is not my intention. Now at this point I'll raise the heat, I'll increase it to full flame and I'll add the fish. And I'll boil for 4 to 5 minutes so that the fishes get cooked well. Here's the famous Bengali recipe. Tel koi or climbing perch in oily gravy is already ready to be served. And the best way to eat and enjoy it is with hot rice. So happy cooking, my dear friends. And please don't forget to subscribe our channel, Amader Bangalir Ranna Ghor.